Today we are going to see a short story by Ken Liu. The Paper Menagerie is the title of the short story. This short story talks about the diasporic experience of a mother and son. In this short story, we have three major characters, father, mother and son. In this short story, we can see how first generation and second generation immigrants suffer and struggle a lot in a foreign land. This short story is narrated through the son, the second generation immigrant. When the short story begins, we are introduced to two characters first, mother and son. This mother is Chinese by origin, but she married an American and got settled in America and given birth to one Chinese boy only. That means he resembles his mother. So when the short story begins, we are introduced to his childhood days. He was very happy with his mother, spending time with his mother all alone. When the story begins, we see him crying. His mother is trying to pacify him by making an animal paper craft, that is origami, which is a part of Chinese culture. This is called paper menagerie. To make origami, she needs papers. She uses only Christmas gift wrappers, which she has collected and kept on the top of the fridge. His mother spoke only in Chinese, and that language gave comfort to him, gave consolation to him in his childhood days. She makes one Laohu origami, that means tiger paper craft, and breathes into it. By breathing into the tiger paper craft, she is giving her life into that paper craft. Then question may arise in our mind, how an American got married with a Chinese woman and got settled in America? To answer this question, the author has given the dim flashback, dim reference here and there. The catalogue is given to the father and he chose her from the catalogue. He doesn't know that she doesn't speak English. It was written that she speaks good English. Later, he understands that she doesn't speak English, but he doesn't object to that. He manages to communicate with her through a paid waitress at the hotel restaurant. So only with the help of the translator, they got married. The cultural blending began. In the beginning of the short story, we have seen that Jack demanded one Laohu origami, that is tiger paper craft. After that, he demanded an origami of a goat, deer, a water buffalo from his mother. And with those wrapping papers, the mother made all those paper craft animals. He played with the puffed origami till it is puffed off. So native culture is reframed or restructured or recreated through this origami animals. And then we see Jack is playing with the Laohu origami, that is tiger paper menagerie. This Chinese Laohu pounced at real sparrows in America and got its ear torn. This denotes that the cultural clash. I told you the ear of Laohu was torn by the real sparrows in America. But Jack's mother made it patched with tape. That Laohu avoided birds after that. That denotes that after clashing with the Western culture, their own culture is getting weakened in foreign land. We have seen how origami Laohu was torn by that real sparrows. Then we are going to see about origami shark. Jack saw one real shark in the TV documentary, and so he asked his mother, he too wanted that as an origami to play. When he got his shark origami, he dropped it in the sink full water and allowed to swim around happily. But it sank down and unfolded itself. On seeing this wet origami shark, he imagined that Laohu origami is also feeling weakened. So Jack felt guilty of his action. So the point here is, the imaginary recreated thing cannot be fixed in the real world. The imaginary recreated origami cannot fix in the real world of America. To console him, Jack's mother recreated another shark origami using tin foil. With this tin foil shark origami, he played well. He made it swim in the goldfish bowl and chase the goldfish. It shows that It is because of this Jack's mother, the native culture is brought back alive. Everything was quite well up to this. The cultural clash began when they moved to a new house across town. Two neighbors visited their house to welcome them actually, but they ridiculed the boy's slang when he tells his name. They ridiculed his appearance also, saying he is a little monster. They ridiculed everyone in the house in the presence of the boy. This is the first cultural attack the boy experienced in his early part of his life. When he told his name to them, they said that he pronounced Chinese. They made fun of the father's choice of marrying a Chinese woman also. This is the first cultural attack the son has experienced. The second cross-cultural confrontation for Jack comes through the neighborhood boy called Mark. He comes to his house with his Star Wars action figures. He laughs at Jack's origami, saying it is made of trash. He talks highly of his own expensive toys. When he ridicules his origami, when he ridicules his paper managery, Lauho leaped at Mark's face as if it is attacking him. So out of fear and surprise, he crumpled and balled up the paper and threw at Jack's face, saying, "Here is your stupid, cheap Chinese garbage." After his exit, Jack tried hard to refold Lauho, and when he was doing it, it seems all the other animals gathered around them and watching it. The third time also he faced cultural attack. That happened in his school. At school also, Jack was bullied of his physical appearance. They bullied him, saying that he had a chink face. He doesn't like to look like his mother. So he went near his mirror and checked whether he is having a face like his mother. The father comforted the worried boy. The mother doesn't understand the meaning for the word chink. So he asked, "What is the meaning for chink?" She asked. For that, the boy got very angry and he showed his anger to his Chinese mother. She speaks Chinese always. On hearing this Chinese language, he ordered her to speak English and cook American food only. He says his mother doesn't belong to this place. The father understands that his son was bullied in his school and so comforted him, saying he doesn't have a chink face. The father is an American, but he doesn't object his own wife cooking Chinese food in America. He had his food with the chopsticks only. But when the son compelled his mother to speak in English and demanded American food, he asked her to follow his orders. Because he understands that his son is trying to fit in the society. She explained her husband why she wants to talk in Chinese. She explained how she feels like talking from her heart when she speaks Chinese. But he doesn't pay heed to her words. He merely said, "You are in America." So the mother is completely shattered. Her condition is like water buffalo without any life in it. Lauho has taken the air of life out of water buffalo by pouncing on it. Lauho represents the boy. Water buffalo represents the mother. The mother is trying to follow her tradition in the foreign land, but the son assimilates the foreign culture and compels his mother also to do so. Jack demanded Star Wars action figures from his father. After asking that, he packed all the origami animals in a large shoebox. In his childhood days, he was happy with his origami animals. But now, he packed all those origami animals in the shoebox. That shows how he feels like they are actually filthy.